Hi guys, a very warm welcome. This is Sanaram. Today, I'm going to start this video with a very short story and tell you the moral, or I would say a solution for this specific problem which usually happens in a family. Let us assume that we have a couple here. This couple is happily married, wife is a housewife, husband is working, well-settled family. Wife is not much bothered about what husband is doing with money because whatever is needed is given to her. They have two more kids, happily traveling the life. Suddenly what happens? Husband gets a heart attack and dies on the spot. Now the question is, what will the wife do? She doesn't know if there is any term insurance. She didn't even know the ATM card pin. Neither did she know whether they had any investments, assets, liabilities, was there any loan, nothing, no information. To be frank, husband has actually secured the whole family, has taken a term insurance, has invested in a number of places, has also bought assets. They have loan as well. But what is the use of having all this when the person who has to know everything knows nothing about it? And when you know nothing about something, how do you even use it for your own use or up to the maximum capability when it can serve for you? This is the story of most of the family. When it comes to finance, couples choose to take two different paths. Apart from that, they are always in the same road, holding hands to hand. But why this happens when it comes to finance? Two reasons. If both are earning, both want their own life. Though they meet at some point when it comes to finance, rest of the time they are always together. But finance, they would like to meet only at some point. Rest of the time, they want to have their own life. They want to go out, they want to shop. They don't want anyone to come and question them because all of us are like that. We earn, so we spend. Why someone has to question us? That is fine when you are single, when you are not married, when your parents are taking care of you and you are earning by yourself. Maybe that time you will not be patient. But when it comes to a marriage life, it is a commitment. One on the other is dependent on you. Maybe a kid or your wife or your husband. Someone there is dependent on you. So in order to make their life secure, they have to know what is actually going on with you and your family financially. On the other side, wife might be taking care of the home and has been given sufficient financial support by the husband, so he is not showing much interest in actually understanding what is going on there. This might be of two cases, extremes. One, husband is actually struggling without having a proper stable financial background but is somehow managing the family. Wife knows nothing about it, husband is completely stressed, might fall sick. On the second side, husband earns so much of money. Since wife is not actually bothered about it, spends it and enjoys the life. This is another extreme. But wherever, in whichever scenario it is, whether they both earn and choose to take different paths, or husband is earning and wife is not bothered, husband is stressing because of instability or is enjoying the stability, everything is a mess here. Because if anything happens to husband, like it happened in the story, wife is going to become a question mark there. So what do we do here? Two things I would like to convey through this video. First, pick up your laptop or your system. Open an Excel if you're good at it, or go for a Word document. Start writing all the investments you have made, all the insurances you have, all the loans you have taken, all the assets you have bought, any liabilities if there. Mention everything with complete details so that anything happens to you in your life suddenly, because life is completely uncertain, your wife and your children will not be in trouble. So this document which you are taking in should also consist the emergency number to which they can contact in case if they don't understand what is written there. So this goes into a pen drive and this pen drive goes into your locker. And monthly once, sit with your parents and with your partner and your children if they are mature enough to understand what you're speaking about, and let them know about what is actually going in the house. Even if you're going through a tough time, it is okay to tell them that I'm not having sufficient amount of money. Or if you're having excess flow of money, you can tell them, I'm having an excess flow of money, maybe I should start a business, do you have any ideas? Anything might work. But let them know what you're actually going through. Most of the men have this problem because they suppress it within them, which is actually not good. Be it too much of happiness or too much of sadness. Anything too much or beyond the limit is not good. So once in a month, a briefing about the financial status or the stability of you and your family with everyone is good. And choosing of nominee, make a wise decision. Just relax and think, who has to be your nominee. Maybe if your parents are completely stable and you think that they can manage their life, maybe you can completely choose your partner as your nominee. Or if you think both of them need good amount of support, go and give them as your nominees. This applies to both male and female, wife and husband. Here there is no discrimination because both of them have to take care of their parents and both of them have to take care of your partners. So two things what I would like to say in this video. First one, let your partner know the complete financial status of you and your family so that in case an emergency arises, she will be able to manage it or he will be able to manage it in rare cases. And then nomination should be done in a very clever way. Who is completely dependent on you? That name has to be in nomination. So make sure you follow these two things in your life so that you and your family are secured, and even after you, your family is secured. And this is Sanaram again signing off from this wonderful video. Just passed on two wonderful tips to you. Follow it. I'll catch you again in the next video. Until then, you guys, if you get any queries related to finance, just give us a missed call to 0226181611. Our money doctors will be getting in touch with you. Let them know about your queries and they will assist you with the same. As I always say, you take care of yourself. Thank you.